In the previous video, I finished assembling the control board for the inverter. In this video, I'll be assembling the power board and completing the software for it. This is just a prototype circuit. To perform a full load test, we'll need a large enough transformer. According to my calculations, for a 10 kilowatt output, you would need a toroidal transformer weighing around 20 kilodrends. For now, I'll use a transformer taken from a UPS to test its basic functions. Once everything is stable, I'll move on to testing with higher power. You can see that the measured parameters on the screen are quite close to the actual values from voltage and current to power. Everything is working very well. If any parameter is off compared to the real readings, we can easily calibrate it through the settings menu. Thanks to JLCPCB for generously sponsoring this project. Many of my projects probably wouldn't have been possible without their support. You can support my work by using JLCPCB's PCB and PCBA services. Also, if you sign up for an account today, you can get coupons worth up to $60 for their services. Go ahead and sign up now. You might not know this, but besides PCB manufacturing, they also supply electronic components for PCBA services, provide mechanical parts, and offer 3D printing and CNC machining services on both plastic and metal materials. You can find out more through the link in the description below my video. And here is the PCB I received from JLCPCB after a little over a week of waiting. They look absolutely great, and all technical specifications meet the standards. This is the power PCB for my high-power inverter project, designed for a continuous output of 10 kilowatts. For continuous 10 kilowatts output, I had to use 40 MOSFETs rated at 148s each to ensure the system can run non-stop without overheating. Just soldering all the gate resistors and gate discharge diodes alone was exhausting. The number of components is truly massive. These components that look like small pins are shunt resistors. Each one has a resistance of 5 milliohms, and I'm using 13 of them in parallel. At maximum power, about 200 atts of current will flow through them. The voltage drop across these shunt resistors will be fed into a differential amplifier to be amplified roughly 100 times before being sent to the microcontroller for processing. Next, I'll be soldering the power MOSFETs. I need 40 MOSFETs rated at 140 amps each. I'm using brand new MOSFETs and they cost about $1 each when bought in bulk. Another extremely important component is the capacitors. To handle 10 kilowatts of power, I'll be using 6 10,000 URF capacitors along with 5 mica capacitors for noise filtering. In general, the more capacitance, the better. After soldering the components, we'll connect the control board, the power board, and the display together. I also added a small ferrite core to the current sensor wire to reduce noise on the current sensing line. Of course, to get the circuit working, we need to upload the program to the control board. Here, I'm using Arduino with over 1,000 lines of code covering all the functions. The code runs very well and meets all my requirements. Right now, I'm using a small transformer taken from an old UPS to test the functions. The inverter is working very well. All the protection features are functioning perfectly, and the control menu is user-friendly. You can see the inverter's parameters in this test video. The readings are completely accurate compared to external measuring instruments.